Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 62 of our Golang course, continuing the journey of Ghost and Relay packages. In this lesson, we will look at net/http package. It provides all the functionality to build and work with an HTTP client or server. Let's first build a little background on HTTP. HTTP, which stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol, is a dominant protocol or a set of rules defining how data is exchanged between web clients and services. If you are aware of the OSI network model, HTTP protocol is an application layer protocol that sits at the top, which is layer 7. I won't go into details of HTTP in the hope that you have the working knowledge of HTTP standards like request methods and response statuses. But if you have any questions, please feel free to ask in the comments below. Our focus of this lesson is going to be HTTP client. The net/http package has a default client that can be used to make requests, but it is highly discouraged as it does not have any timeout configured, which could leave your client hanging, waiting for server to respond and exhaust resources. The HTTP package also provides functions to perform various operations like making GET POST requests. But again, this is not recommended as you can configure the requests you are making. We will see that in our example. So what should you do then? You should create your custom client. You can do this by using the client struct defined in the HTTP package. It can be used to configure the timeout. So let's have a look at it with an example. Before diving into the example, I just want to let you know that for this lesson, we are going to use the board API, which is free API without any authentication needed. So we are going to make a call to this URL and expect this response. Let's copy this so that we can create a struct to model the response in a program. Here in the package main, let me just paste the response. Now, first, let us map this response to a Go struct. I'm going to create a struct boring response. To map it, let us create all the fields in the JSON response. Activity is a string and the JSON field is mapped to activity. Similarly, I have mapped all the other fields in the response. As you can see, type is a string, participants is an int, price is an int as well. Let's convert that to float as you can have it in a decimal value. Float 64, link is again a string, key again a string, and accessibility is a float again. Let's save it. Now that we have the boring response mapped, let us now make the request. To make a request, we need to first create a custom client. As I told you, we shouldn't be using the default client provided by the package as it does not have any timeout configured. Context.background. This is required to create a request with a context. Context is something that we'll cover in our upcoming lesson. Now I can do client and do http.client. As you can see, we are not going to use the default client. Instead, we will create our own. Now, let's configure the timeout. Since it's a duration, I can say 10 into time into second. Now, let's create a request, which would have all the required details to make the request. http.newRequest with context. Context, as you can see, first thing is the context. Then we provide the method string, a URL, and a body. For method, we will use exported constant from the HTTP package, which is method get. And URL, let's copy the one we just looked at in the docs. For body, since this is a GET request, we don't need to provide any body, so I can just do nil. If we have any problems creating a request, we will log it to console and return. So we say error creating a request and then just return it. Now let's make the request. Response error. You can do it by calling the do method on the HTTP client, which, as you can see, accepts a HTTP request, which we get from calling http.newRequest with context. So I can pass the request, and similar to what we did before, if there's an error, we will log it and then return. As we have seen in the previous lessons, it is always good to take care of resources. So we can defer response.body.close. Body is of type read_closer. So we can defer the closing after we have read the body. Now I'm going to use the struct that we created to unmarshal the response. First, let us create a variable boring res, which is of type boring response. Then we are going to use json.newDecoder, creating the decoder using response.body and decode it into our boring response. Decode with return error, so we can do if error colon equal, error not is equal to nil, print it to the console. If we didn't encounter any error, that means we have successfully read the response. In that case, let us print it to the console. FMT printf and provide the plus V verb, which means that it will print the field name and the field value. So that's our program. Let us revise what we did. First, we created a context with context.background. Again, context is something that we'll cover in a future lesson. Then we create a custom client by calling http.client. You can configure the transport, the check redirect to handle redirect as you like, and few other things like timeout. So we configured a timeout of 10 seconds. That is, if we don't get a response in 10 seconds, the connection should be closed. Then we created a new request by calling http.newRequest with context, passing in the context, the method of our request, and the URL for the API. We passed a nil body since get doesn't allow passing a body and we don't need it. If there's an error, we print it to the console. Next, we made a request by calling the do method on the client we created earlier. Then, if there's no error, we close the response body by deferring it. And in the end, we decode whatever response we get from the boring API and then log it to the console. Let's run our program to verify the response. And as you can see, we were successfully able to unmarshal the response into our boring response struct. Activity: learn the Chinese. Type: music, participants 1, price 0.6, link is not there, key, and then accessibility. So that's basically how you would make a HTTP request. Please note that if server sends an error response, that is, sets the status to error status, this call won't error out. Instead, you would have to check it yourself. This can be done through accessing status on the response. If response.statuscode, and then again, we will use some constants defined in the HTTP package. If status is not okay, we want to error out printing the status response that we got from the server. Response.status. Now let's save our program and run it again. I forgot to return here, but we can see that we were able to get the response. If I change it to something like status not found, that is, if the response status from the server is not 404, then we log an error and return. In this case, we should log an error since the status sent by the server is 200. And as you can see, we got 200 instead of what we were expecting, which is status not found. This is just for demonstration purposes, but usually it's status okay, which is not an error response like status not found. Just to verify everything is working, let us run a program. And as you can see, we were able to get the response from it. That's it for the lesson. Now let's summarize everything we have learned. We learned that the net HTTP package provides all the functionality to work with HTTP. In this case, we learned how we can use the client provided by the HTTP package to make a request or to make a GET request. In case we were making a POST request, you can pass the body. As you can see, the body is an IO reader. Usually, what you would do is encode the JSON or marshal the JSON and provide the IO reader implementation as the body. Try it yourself and let me know if you encounter any problems. So, as we saw, we can make HTTP requests with the client provided by the HTTP package, which comes in very handy. You can configure it as per your needs. And remember, please don't use the default client unless you are performing any tests, as it does not have any timeout configure. That's it for the lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please feel free to post a comment under the video or reach out to our Discord server. Until next time, happy coding!